Bait lighting is a common technique used in game design that pre-computes lighting in a static environment and bakes the illuminated and non-lit areas onto a special texture called a light map. As the hardware is spared the effort of calculating light during runtime, this technique delivers far better performance than its dynamic counterparts at the cost of flexibility. Since it is immutable by design, it is best suited for indestructible light sources that do not change and cannot change over entire game sessions, however long they may last. A good example is outdoor ambient lighting in games that lack day and night cycles, such as Battlefield 3. When developers flout this guideline, the results tend to be immediately noticeable. Ghost Recon Wildlands provides a stark example of baked lighting gone funny. Approaching the wooden warehouse, we shoot the outer lamp. The light bulb is destroyed, but the illumination persists seemingly with no source in sight. The floodlights facing the warehouse fare better, going dark after they have all been destroyed. The same goes for the streetlight, which shuts down like expected. Revisiting the interior, we find more flawed implementations. Shooting out the ceiling lamp has no effect on the lighting, with even the halo around the lamp persisting long after the destruction of its supposed light source. One way developers work around the issue is by making the light sources indestructible. Rainbow Six Siege provides a good example where shooting the light has little effect beyond making it flicker at the moment of impact. Thank you for watching our short analysis of baked lighting. Our next video will explore what makes a good PC port. Be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss out.